Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you are good. So today we are going to see some of the service now indication related questions which are being asked frequently in interview nowadays. So these questions are very important. So guys, I always try to make my videos very simple and very easy to understand, so you can easily understand like whatever topic I'm explaining. But still you have any doubt, feel free to post your questions in the comment section. I'll definitely try to answer them. So without any delay, let's get started. So our first question is, what is ServiceNow integration? And in general also, what is integration? So integration means establishing the connection between two applications or systems so they can interact with each other. So if you want to have interaction between two systems or application, we have to make connection between both of them. Then only they can interact with each other, right? So in simple language, application can communicate with each other or move the data between each other, okay? So basically, we can send the data or receive the data from third-party tool or any another application to ServiceNow. So guys, if we want to send the data from ServiceNow to third-party tool, so there should be connection between ServiceNow and third-party tool. Then only ServiceNow will be able to send the data to third-party tool, and third party will be able to receive the data from ServiceNow. If there is no connection, how can we send the data from ServiceNow to third party tool or vice versa, right? So ServiceNow platform allows direct integration for software, infrastructure, product or APIs. This will enable your enterprise to transfer the data from legacy system into platform, as well export the data from ServiceNow into applicable system. So our second question is, what is unidirectional and bidirectional integration? So unidirectional interface sends data in only one direction from a sender to a receiver. So unidirectional relationship has only an owning side. So it is single way communication, only data will be sent from sender to receiver. And bidirectional interface involves the exchange of data between two systems. So sender can send the data and receive the data as well. So bidirectional communication will happen in bidirectional integration, and bidirectional relationship has both an owning side and an inverse side. So here both side communication will happen. I mean, there is source and target system. Source system can send the data to target system, and target system can receive the data from source system, and vice versa. Even target system will able to send the data to source, and source data will be able to receive the data from target. So communication and data transfer will happen both the side. Okay, so next question is, what is inbound integration in ServiceNow? So inbound web services are designed to provide third parties with the ability to retrieve or update data in ServiceNow. So inbound means that other application make calls to ServiceNow REST API to get information from ServiceNow, or it can create or update the record. So whatever action will happen, it is going to happen in ServiceNow. So in inbound integration, request will come to ServiceNow from other system or third party tool, and the request is being acknowledged in ServiceNow, and as part of acknowledgement, response will be sent to other tool from ServiceNow. So now let's talk about what is outbound integration in ServiceNow. So outbound means the ServiceNow makes call to another application, REST API, to get information from the other application or create and update the record. So ServiceNow is going to request to third party tool or other application, and whatever action will happen, it will happen in the third party tool. So while outbound web services allow ServiceNow to initiate a transaction with the third party tool using any HTTP method like GET or POST, etc. So mainly, incident will be created in target system, other application or third party tool, and request will be sent to target system from ServiceNow. So ServiceNow will send the request to target system or third party tool, and that request will be acknowledged in target system, and response will be sent to ServiceNow. So ServiceNow make a request to third party tool, and as part of acknowledgement, response will come to ServiceNow from third party tool. So now let's talk about difference between REST and SOAP API. So RIST stands for representational state transfer, whereas SOAP stands for simple object access protocol. So RIST is an architectural pattern where SOAP is a protocol. RIST works with plain text, XML, HTML and JSON, whereas SOAP only works with XML format for communication and transfer of data through browser. So RIST does not need much bandwidth, whereas SOAP needs much bandwidth for its uses. So RIST has SSL and HTTPS for security. On the other hand, SOAP has SSL secure socket layer, which is called, and WS security, due to which in the cases like bank account, password, card number, etc., SOAP is preferred over RIST because SOAP integration is more secure than RIST. But RIST is very easy to understand, it's kind of very user friendly and faster than SOAP. So it depends like what we are going to do, like if there is something related to bank, so in that scenario we can use SOAP. If something, you know, any integration with third party tool which is required fast and friendly, so RIST can be used. It totally dependent on the requirement. Okay, so now our next question is, what is REST API in ServiceNow? So we have already understood REST stands for representational state transfer. So REST API were designed to take advantage of existing protocols. Okay. ServiceNow tool provides a variety of methods to integrate with other applications such as Jira, event monitoring tool, LDAP, etc. using REST API. So we are having existing protocols, so we can make use of them and we can very easily integrate the ServiceNow with any other application. Okay. So you can use REST interfaces to access data on your instance. ServiceNow REST API Explorer is an application to construct and test APIs request to a ServiceNow instance. So there's one application called REST API Explorer. So you can construct API using REST API Explorer and you can do the testing also. Inbound web services such as the REST API allow you to interact with ServiceNow instance data using web services request. ServiceNow outbound REST functionality allow you to retrieve, create, update or delete data on a web services server that supports the REST architecture. So these all are the advantages of REST, and you might have understood what all can be done by using REST API in ServiceNow. So our next question is, what is table and import state API? So what is table state API and import state API? So the table API allow you to perform create, read, update and delete mainly crude operation on existing tables and retrieves multiple records for the specified table. Okay. So by using table state API, we can do crude operation on existing tables and we can retrieve the multiple records for the specified table. Okay. And the import state API allows you to interact with import state tables. The import state table is basically a staging table, right, which we create in integration, and while even data load we create import state, right? So it allows you to interact with import state tables and API transforms incoming data based on the associated transform maps. The import set API supports synchronous transforms. Okay. Now, what are response and request objects? So you might have heard about it. We are having request and response object in REST integration, right? So what is that? So let's try to understand. Request and response is a message exchange pattern in which a requester sends a request message to a target system. The target system receives and processes the request, and if all goes well, it will return a message in term of response. So whenever, you know, requester send a request message to request anything to the target, you know, system, it is called request. And as part of acknowledgement, target system will receive that data and it will process that request and it will send the response as part of acknowledgement. That is called response. So request is sent by the client to trigger an action on the server and response the answer from the server. Okay. Request is sent to target system to request something. In response to the request, acknowledgement is sent from the target, that is response. I think it's quite clear. Okay. If you have any issue, you can let me know in comment section. So next question is, what are HTTPS methods? So HTTPS means Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So which is an application layer protocol for distributed, collaborative and hypermedia information system. It is foundation of data communication for the worldwide. So HTTPS means Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So which is used as a data communication in the worldwide. Okay. So HTTP functions as a request response protocol in the client server computing model. HTTP specification specifies how client request data will be constructed and sent to the server and how the servers respond to this request. So as part of any communication, there is request and response, right? So request will be sent to the target system and as part of acknowledgement will get the response, right? So HTTP specification specifies how clients request the data which is sent to the server and how server respond to this request. So it's a kind of data communication or data transfer protocol which helps in data transferring from server to client. So now we are going to discuss about types of HTTPS method. Okay. So we are mainly having five types of HTTPS method which we use in integration, ServiceNow integration. So first let's talk about GET. So GET, it is used to retrieve or read the record from the given server. So GET method is used whenever we need to fetch the data from another application or from server. So GET is used to read the record from another server. Okay. And POST is used to create a new record from the given API. So if we have to create a new record in a target system, so we have to use POST HTTP method. And now let's talk about put and patch. So put is used to update the partial or a specific record. Okay. It will check if resource exists, then it will update the record or else it will create the new record. If the record is not existing in a target system, what it will do? It will create a new record. And now let's understand what is patch. So patch is used to update the whole record. Okay. So it will always update a resource. Okay. And delete, it's quite simple. Delete is used to delete the record in server or another application. And you can see it target system. So now we are having this question, REST API authentication methods. So commonly what all REST API authentication method we use in ServiceNow. So basically we use two kind of authentication method. First one is basic and second one is oath. So first we'll try to understand what is basic. So to create a basic, you know, authentication, we have to create a basic auth profile to specify the basic authentication that contain the credential. And as part of credential, username and password of the target system. So in target system, we have to create credential same as source system. Okay. Username and password. Okay. In oath, what we do? Oath is an open standard for token based authentication. So in oath, authentication will be generated as token. It allows user access instance resources by obtaining token rather than entering login credential with each resource request. So in oath, user has to use token. It is not required to use यूजर नेम एंड क्रेडिट पासवर्ड ईच एंड एवरी टाइम वेन एवर दे आर ट्राइंग टू एक्सेस. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वॉट इज इंड पॉइंट एंड हाउ टू कॉन्फिगर इट. ओके, सो एन इंड पॉइंट इज वन एंड ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन चैनल. When an API interacts with another system, the touch points of this communication are considered as endpoint. For APIs, an endpoint can include a URL of a server or service, the place that APIs send requests and where the resource lives is called an endpoint. Okay, and how can you configure it? So you can use REST API Explorer and scripted REST API to configure the endpoint. Okay. So now what is difference between API and endpoint? So an API is a set of protocol and tools that allow two applications to communicate. Okay. On the other hand, an endpoint is a URL that enables the API to access resources on a server. Okay. The place that APIs send requests and where the resource lives is called an endpoint. So let's move to next slide. So how to test ServiceNow REST API through third party tool? So if you have already created REST API, okay, so how can you test it whether it's valid or not, or whether it's working as expected or not? So you can test it by using third party tool called Postman. So by using Postman, you can test it. For that, for testing purpose, you need ServiceNow endpoint and credential to send a request to ServiceNow through Postman. Okay, so this is how you can do the testing through third party tool as well. So guys, this was the last question of this video. So I'm going to post another set of integration question in my next video. So that's all. Thanks for watching.